this is me right now, trying to come to grips with what is about to happen. I've just been on two long flights because I don't think there's any place which is holier, especially for a motorcyclist. For you and I are about to embark on the journey of a lifetime. One of the most prestigious races, which is over 100 years old. You and I are going to the Isle of Man to witness the Tourist Trophy 2015 from close quarters.
This is the Isle of Man, and I had sworn that the first time I come here, I'm going to do something, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. That's what I want to do. That's the Mezzello village. Beautiful tent set up for us journalists and other fellow riders who have come here to the Isle of Man. It's a brilliant facility. I would definitely come back and would still want to stay here because this is where you're right in the heart of all the action. I mean, to be listening to all these motorcycles zoom away all through the night is just fantastic. I cannot believe I'm here. Getting back to the point, so Douglas it is, but we're having dinner tonight and it's supposed to be something else.
Morning guys, we have woken up to another beautiful morning here at the Isle of Man. To be honest, I still can't believe that I'm here. Here are a few facts for you to consider. Apparently this year there are already about 42,000 more tourists at the Isle of Man than there were last year. And last year the count was around 82,000. It's already like over 120,000 people who are here on this tiny island to witness the Tourist Trophy. In other words, just completely packed out. It's a full house here. And the only reason that I could be here was thanks to Pirelli. We are here with the brand Mezzello, which is the tire used by many of participants, including Guy Martin and Hutchinson, who is on fire this year. He's already won two races. You want to know the science which goes into making a tire to race at the Isle of Man. Because if you crash at the Isle of Man and if you're still alive, you're a very lucky man.
TT races are, again, something apart really. You can easily imagine it's a really long track, more than 37 miles, different kind of tarmac, different kind of conditioning. The tire has to deliver consistency from the beginning to the end, but also the tire has to be capable to absorb the damping. We are talking about a road, it's not a track. The tarmac is not always flat, and so these tires, together with the machine, has to be able to absorb the damping and let the riders reach the maximum speed and feel confident. Over these days, the top racers have been using the Race Tech RR. If you succeed at the TT, for sure you succeed on the road.
I'm going to tell you a story about Agostini, so I'll tell you a story. So just along here, there's a famous part where somebody called Gwen used to stand, and she was one of the official markers, and she would mark all the riders through to make sure everybody's going through at this part of the track. And Agostini broke down here one day, and he happened to go in and have coffee for it with there. So Agostini went in there and he wasn't seen for 48 hours.
Around the Isle of Man, and it was everything that I expected and so much more. Right now we are going for lunch on the beautiful mountain up there. There's a hotel there. Yeah, and after that we are heading to the paddock. We are at the start-finish line, and right now I'm standing in the pits. I'm sure all of you must have seen it as many times in videos as I have, but to stand here right now in reality is I can't put enough emphasis on how important the pit stop is. I mean, to put things into perspective, let's take Michael Dunlop in the Superbike TT, right? If his team would have managed to get him even faster, even quicker pit stops,
then he would have closed into Bruce Anstey a lot quicker and wouldn't have as much pressure in the last lap, which eventually caused him to crash and never finish the race. And not just that, now he has an injury which he's going to carry tomorrow in the most important race, the Senior TT.
That was one brilliant session. All the Medzilla racers who are going to be racing tomorrow in the TT. Guy Martin couldn't make it, but he had a splendid time with Ian Hutchinson, Gary, James, and that was a fantastic question and a round.
Okay, I know I mentioned 2 minutes ago that Guy could not make it, but I was wrong, because he's here.
Very last one, Guy, this Indian friend. He met you in India.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Guy Martin of Power Drift.
Hello, PD Army. This is your Sergeant Sheldy reporting from the beautiful, beautiful island of the Isle of Man on the eve of the Senior TT. I am at the Craignabar, which I'm told is one of the best places to see the action. You have two long straights behind you, so that's one straight, and there's one right there, yeah, coming down the mountain, which gives you as a spectator more than enough time to hear the bikes, to see them coming, cutting down the straight, going down a couple of gears, taking this right-hander, and again getting back on full throttle towards the grandstand. That, ladies and gentlemen, was the Senior TT, and the legend of John McGuinness just keeps growing. I mean, what is that man made of? 23rd win. The second guy is not Hutchie, it was James Hillier. It's been a fantastic race. I enjoyed it. I've always wanted to come here ever since I started racing. And to be here to experience this is just unbelievable. So that's me, Sergeant Sheldy from Power Drift, signing off from this beautiful island of the Isle of Man.
The time which I've been dreading has finally come, but it's time for me to get on a plane and leave this beautiful island. The island which plays host to the most beautiful race on earth, the Isle of Man TT. And what a show by Medzilla. With 4 race wins, this has been by far their most impressive showing here at the Isle of Man. It also goes to show all the new tires that they have developed here on the Isle of Man are definitely working.
I'm not sure how this footage is going to come out, because the entire time, ever since I've stepped on the soil, I have been extremely overwhelmed. See, I can't even say the word. Yeah, never.